Into another online Zoom teaching. Today we are going to look at probability in the general mathematics. Have in mind you can have an access to this video by clicking or searching on Momokini YouTube. Just search Momokini on YouTube. For those of you who are on WeChat, you can also use momokini36@gmail.com. Now we are going to look at our probability. We can define probability here as the tendency for an event to occur or not. That means the tendency for an event to occur or not to occur. So as a result of that, the actual relationship that you can put for probability will be that probability becomes the required event divided by the total event. Required event divided by total event. So the definition I said for probability is the tendency for an event to occur or not. That means if you are taking an exam, there is tendency for you to pass that exam or the tendency for you to fail. So as a result of that, the required event, the probability is calculated using required event divided by the total event. Whatever that you require divided by the total event. So what do we mean by that? That means if you have in the class, let us say in the class you have 10 boys in that particular class and there are 20 girls in the class. Now somebody will say you find the probability of boys. Find the probability of boys. What the person is requiring now will be the boys. He is interested in the number of boys. So if the person is interested in the number of boys, that means the required event, the numerator becomes the boys here. So the probability of the boys will be the total number of boys divided by the total event. The total event can be boys and girls. That means 10 plus 20. That is going to be 10 divided by 10 plus 20 is 30. This will cancel. You have 1 over 3 there. That is how you can analyze the probability phase. Now, if that is the case, there are terms that are used to describe these probability things. Now, the terms that we can make use of to describe the probability will depend on two ledgers. We make use of ledgers here. That means the registers. If you can recall ledgers and structure, there will be a register that we use. We have the word tossing, and we have rolling. Depending on the object you want to describe, you can toss a die, and then you roll a coin. You can roll a coin. But that will not bother you much. You can use any one of them. You can interchange them. If you cannot recall, instead of you wasting time, you can even say tossing a coin, if that is what can help you best. You can even say rolling a die. That will not bother much on the analysis. So you toss the actual expression, you toss a die, and then you roll a coin. If that is the case, we are now going to look at the terms, basic terms that are used. Terms used. The basic terms that are used are, one, you roll, rolling a die once. You roll a die once. What do we mean by rolling a die once? That means you have a die, a single die, you send that die. Anytime you have one die, you send it. Each and every one of you who normally play Ludo, or you have been seeing people playing the Ludo game, you know what a die is. The singular is the die and the plural become dice. So if you have one die, you send that for the first time, there will be a result that you can get. You can either see number one, or number two, or number three, or number four, or number five, or number six. That means anytime you send a die one time, you expect six results. Anytime a die is sent once, you expect six results. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So you say total outcome is equal to 6. Now somebody will say find the probability of 4. Find the probability of 4. If you look at the outcome here, 4 will only occur once. The moment you send one die, the moment 4 comes, no other number will not appear again. Therefore, 4 occurs once. 1 divided by the total outcome is 6. The required value we need is 4, and it appears 1 divided by the total 6. The probability of number 2 also is 1 over 6, because 2 occurs 1 divided by the total here 6. That means the probability of any one of the number occurring is 1 divided by 6. We go to the second term. The second term in the analysis is rolling a die twice. Now this is a little bit skeptical. What does that mean? There are two ways in which the question will be put. Either the question says you send one die two times. That is what you are seeing here. Rolling a die twice means you send one die two times. That means you have to send the die. You take it, you send it for the second time. If you don't want to do that, they will say send two dice together. If you don't want to send one die two times to waste time, you can send two dice together. So on the question paper, either somebody says you send one die two times or you have to send two dice together. That is the same. Now let us look at the result. When you send one die, we said you can either get number one or two or three or four or five or six. That is for one die. The second die will give us one or two or three or four or five or six. Now we cross them. We have one here and one here. That means it is possible that you can get one on the first die, one on the second, one, two, one on the first, two on the second, one, three, one, four, one, five, one, six. We have 2-1, 2-2, 2-3, 2-4, 2-5, 2-6. We have 3-1, 3-2, 3-3, 3-4, 3-5, 3-6. We can get 4-1, 4-2, 4-3, 4-4, 4-5, 4-6. You can get 5-1, 5-2, 5-3, 5-4, 5-5, 5-6. You can get 6-1, 6-2, 6-3, 6-4, 6-5, and 6-6. So when you count the expected results, anytime you send two dice together or you send one die two times, you expect 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36. So anytime you send one die two times or you send two dice together, you expect 36 results. Total outcome is equal to 36. Let us now say somebody says, find the probability of sum of 8. Sum of 8 means two numbers among this set that you can add to get 8. What are two sets of numbers you can add to get 8? And have in mind, whatever set you take, it must be in straight line. Now, if I add 6 and 2, I will get 8. I add 5 and 3, I will get 8. I add 4 and 4, I will get 8. 3 and 5, I will get 8. 2 and 6, I will get 8. That maintains this straight line. Apart from that straight line, you will not have any two other sets that you can add to get 8. So we have a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of them. Probability means total outcome, required event divided by total event. The required event is sum of 8. And sum of 8, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of them, divided by total outcome, 36. That will be the answer to that. Let us go to term number 3. It takes us to term number 3 that is used in describing and analyzing the probability. And term number 3 is now, you now tossing a coin. Tossing a coin once. You are familiar with a coin. That means you can either use the 500 leone when you are in Sierra Leone, you can use 500 leone. And a coin has two phases. There are two sides. Two sides to a coin. So since there are two sides to a coin, there is a particular side you can see the head, and then there is another one you see any other shape, which we call the tail. So as a result of that, anytime you toss a coin, you either expect the head or the tail. So the total outcome that we only expect two results. Anytime you send a coin, you either expect the head or the tail. That means there are two results that you can expect. Somebody will now say, find the probability of the head. How many heads do we have? We have just one. Out of the two results, we have one head. The required event is head, and it appears one, divided by the total event two. The probability of the tail also is one, divided by two. That is the first, the third time. Let us go to time number four. Time number four is tossing a coin twice. What do we mean by tossing a coin twice? Tossing a coin twice means you have one coin, you send it two times. In the exam, if they want to confuse you, they will say sending two coins together. Either you send one coin two times or you just send two coins together. It's the same. You have one coin, you send it, you take it again, you send. Or you can just take two coins and combine them, you send. So let us look at the result. We already know that when one coin is thrown, you either expect the head or the tail. That is for one coin. The other coin again can either produce the head or the tail. So if you cross them here, you get head. That is HH. You can get HT. Head on the first, head on the second, head on the first, tail on the second. You can get TH, that is T, H here and TT, tail on the first, tail on the second. We have 1, 2, 3, 4 results. Total outcome is equal to 4. So anytime you send one coin two times, or you send two coins together, you expect 4 results or 4 outcome. Let us now say, somebody says you find a probability of one head, and one tail. You can get one head and one tail at this point. One head and one tail, you can get it here. You can also get one head and one tail here. So we have two of them, one, two. The required event we need is one head and one tail. And they appear twice, one, two. Two divided by four. Two goes here, one into four, two times. So the answer is 1/2. If somebody says you find the probability of two heads, two heads can only occur one time here. That is 1 divided by total outcome is 4. That is the result. We look at the last time. The last time is tossing a coin twice now, 3 times. Tossing a coin twice, 3 times. This one is the same as you send 3 coins together. So tossing a coin twice means you send one coin 3 times. You have a single coin, you send it, you take it again, you send it, you take it again, you send it for the third time. Or you can just combine 3 coins and send them. That's what we mean. Either you send one coin 3 times or you send 3 coins together. Let us look at the results. We already know the result for 2 coins. We know the result for 2 coins. The result for 2 coins is up here already. For 2 coins, we have head, head tail, tail head, and tail tail. That is, these are the result for 2 coins. We have head, head tail, tail head, and tail tail. These are the result for 2 coins. Now we need one more coin, and that one coin will only produce head or tail. We already know that for one coin, only produces head or tail. So if you can match them, where H coming to H, H here is H, H, H. It is possible that the 3 coins, all of them will produce heads. We have H, H, T. Head on the first, head on the second, tail on the third one. We have H, T, H. Head on the first, tail on the second, and head on the third one. We have H, T, T. Head on the first, tail on the second, tail on the third one. If that will not happen, we get T, H, H. Tail on the first, tail, head on the second, head on the third. We have T, H, T. T, H, T. T, T, H, T, T, H, and we have T, 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 T. So anytime you send one coin 3 times or you send 3 coins together, you expect 8 results. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That means the total outcome is equal to 8. Somebody will now say, find the probability of 2 heads and 1 tail. Let us say you want to find the probability of 2 heads and 1 tail. Count how many times you can get 2 heads and 1 tail. You can get 2 heads and 1 tail here. 1 head, 2 heads, 1 tail. You can get it here. You can get 2 heads here. H, H, 2 heads and 1 tail. You can get them here. You can also get 2 heads and 1 tail here. So there are 3 of them. 1, 2, 3 of them. Required event is 2 heads and 1 tail, and there are 3 divided by the total event, which is 8. If somebody says find the probability of 3 heads, 3 heads only occurs at this point. So it occurs once, divided by total of 8.
Seven.
Save.